listen what he said. Don't be cheated with heavenly titles. And then
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Let us begin our session this morning with a recital of Surah Al-Fatiha. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Our distinguished guest, Shaykh Hisham, Kabbani, Chairman of the Islamic Supreme Council of America, Brother Muhammad Nasir, Managing Director of our Civic Center, and his colleagues, Management Committee, Asatizas, friends and children. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We are very honored today to receive our distinguished guest, Shaykh Hisham, who is a world-renowned Muslim scholar, author, and lecturer. Shaykh Hisham Kabbani received his Islamic Law Sharia degree in Syria. He also studied deeply the subject of Islamic spirituality under two renowned Naqshbandi spiritual guides, namely Shaykh Abdullah Al-Faiz Al-Dagestani and Shaykh Nazim Adil Al-Haqqani. He holds a bachelor degree in chemistry from the American University of Beirut and also studied medicine in Leuven, Belgium. For many years, Shaykh Hisham has publicly condemned all acts of terrorism and the use of Islam to promote terrorist agendas. He has worked ardently to help people all over the world from all walks of life better understand the moderate, tolerant nature of traditional Islam as practiced around the world. Shaykh Hisham has spent his life spreading the teachings of peace and tolerance, respect and love, which are the message of Islam throughout the world. He continues to disseminate the light and peace of Islam's spiritual dimension to people of every background, ethnicity, race, and belief. We would like to thank you, Shaykh, and his entourage, and Brother Muhammad Nasir, for visiting our humble madrasa. And now we'd like to present a slight presentation of the madrasa activities. Thank you. Hisham to deliver his speech.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's an honor and pleasure for me to be today here in this school, which you can see how much effort they did to give you such a nice place, also air conditioned. I don't know if the classes are air conditioned. But alhamdulillah, it's a very nice place. If you look on the side of the building here, you can see how the shape was before. How it was before and how it is today. As you know, we are very proud of these young girls to be studying Islam and secular science together. You are holding the two sides, dunya and akhirah. In one hand, you are holding the secular sciences, which are important in this time, and you are holding the Islamic sciences, which are very important for akhirah. And I will mention to you some of the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the importance of studying. And you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the verse first in Holy Quran was revealed by Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Read in the name of your Lord that He created. The one who created, the beginning to Prophet ﷺ of revelation is to read. And he said, "Utlubu al-ilma walau fi al-sin," seek science, seek knowledge, even if it is in China. And we are near China, I think, here. I am learning also and seeking knowledge here in this country, learning more about the various different cultures, and how you are united, all of you together, in one pot, if we can say. And mashallah, you are a great big community. Anyone say Singapore likes this word to say, to come and visit here. So an Abi Sa'id al-Khidri radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa ardah, it's an authentic hadith from Bukhari and Muslim. He said, قالت النساء للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The ladies said to Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. What does that mean? That means that there was a very strong relationship, that the ladies, they have been authorized and given opportunity to speak with Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So it is not like some people, you ladies cannot speak with a man. Today, there is a restriction between a student and a teacher, especially if he is a man. They cannot speak with him nicely. But look here with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the ladies are telling him, "We have a question, Ya Rasulullah," directly, without knocking at the door and asking permission. غلبنا عليك الرجال فاجعل لنا يوما عن نفسك. They said to him, complaining, saying that the men, they are so much with you always, and we have not an opportunity, right opportunity, to sit with you. Look, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not get upset. When the ladies complained, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not get upset. But he said, say what you want to say. Let me know what are your questions. And they said, وَاجْعَلْ لَنَا يَوْمًا عَنْ نَفْسِكَ. Give us a day. Also, like you are giving them days, give us a day to be with you. They want to be with Prophet ﷺ, with whom they love. What they want to do? They want to learn. So this hadith is for learning. They want to know what also the man knows. So what Prophet told them? Go no sit at home, cook and make the laundry. Or he said, I will give you a day. What he said to them? Sit at home or come to me, I give you one day. Come to me, of course, I give you one day. And then, فَوَعَدَهُنَّ يَوْمًا. He promised them, I will give you one day, I will teach you privately. So all the ladies used to gather together in Medina and come to Prophet ﷺ to learn from him and to study one day with him. Look, today can you sit with a chairman or with a president or with a minister? You cannot. Prophet, he is the seal of messengers. He is the one to want, he is the one that went for Mi'raj. And he said, I will sit with you and teaching you. لَقِيهُهُنَّ فِيهِ فَوَعَظَهُنَّ وَآمَرَهُنَّ مَا مِنْكُنَّ امْرَأَةٌ تُقَدِّمُ ثَلَاثَةً مِنْ أَوْلَادِهَا إِلَّا كَانَ لَهَا حِجَابًا مِنَ النَّارِ. He sat with them, he met with them, he advised them, he ordered them, he taught them, and he said to them, if one of you will give up three of her children to Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you from hellfire. And one lady was clever. فَقَالَتْ امْرَأَةٌ وَاثْنَيْن can be two, because she has two. She didn't have three. And قال وَاثْنَيْن. And he said, yes, for sure, two also. To give to Islam is what? Not to go and fight, but like you. To study Islam, to study your religion, to compete with each other and compete with what men are learning, learn like them. That is the advice of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we see from here that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has big desire for ladies to learn and to study. He didn't say to them, go sit at home. No, he met with them and gave them a lesson. He taught them. What Aisha said, وعن عائشة زوج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, also Bukhari and Muslim, أنها كانت لا تسمع شيئا لا تعرفه إلا رجعت فيه. Sayyida Aisha, the wife of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, all the time in her life, if she didn't know something, she heard it, but she didn't know about it, she goes to the Prophet and asks him, Ya Rasulullah, teach me that, I don't know what is the answer. She didn't keep quiet. So don't keep quiet. Bother your teachers. If you don't bother them, they will not answer you. Sorry, teachers. Bother your teachers. Say, we are not understanding. Sayyida Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha wa arda, she was going to Prophet, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not bothered. She was happy to answer. Because Sayyida Aisha gave most of the ahadith that concern women to people to study, to Sahaba. They were studying with her. Sahaba were studying and learning from Sayyida Aisha many, many issues that concern women in Islam. So be like her, learn from her, inherit her studies. So go to your teacher and say, my teacher, I am learning Islam, I don't understand this. Ask them, they will teach you, they will tell you. Because this is an Islamic school, no one is running after dunya, you are running after akhirah. وأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من حوسب عذب. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yes, of course, ask me, because I don't want you to fall into a mistake, because if Allah is going to account your amal, account any amal of any human being, you are going to be for sure punished, because all of us make sense. So it's better not to be called for judgment in the day of judgment. Let us call and say, Ya Rabbi, Ya Allah, give us from your mercy, forgive us with no account. Because if Allah wants to make an account for every person, most of us will be falling into punishment. Because all of us had made mistake in their lives. Me, you, teachers, everyone. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered her. She answered Prophet. قالت أوليس يقول الله تعالى فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا. Allah said in Holy Quran. She answered Prophet. Look, Prophet said to her, don't try to be judged. Let us run from judgment away by doing well. She said, but Allah said in Holy Quran that Allah is going to judge you, but a nice judge, a simple judge, simply Islam, like your school. Simple judgment. She argued, and Prophet didn't say to her, no, why you are arguing? She wants to understand, she wants to learn. So oh Muslim ladies, the new generation, in this country and all overseas, you are the flower of the new generation. You are the new mothers that you are going to teach your children. Men, with my respect, are not going to sit at home. Women, they have this patience to sit and raise their children and work. Be a pioneer in your class and ask your teacher whatever you don't understand, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you and inspire your heart. Sayyida Aisha said to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, oh my husband, well, you are praying too much. Because she wants to see him. Prophet was always praying. She said, already Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiven you, but still you are praying and your feet are so swollen. It's not enough for you that Allah gave you forgiveness. And he said, Ala akunu abdan shakura? You don't want me to be a thankful servant for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Means, O Muslim, wala in shakartum la azidannakum. What is your duty as young girls? To thank your teachers. To thank that Allah provided you this school. If that school was not here, where you were going to study? So thank your teachers. Thank your supervisor. Thank those who are behind the walls working for you in the offices. Be a thankful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will give you then happiness in dunya and akhirah. العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين استغفر الله. It's a short speech because Muhammad Nasir said don't talk too much here because they are ladies, then they get upset with you. I said okay.
I believe after this, the student will be the advice, and Ustaz Shizaz will be happy to answer all the questions. And I would like you to recite dua for us, and then also our Mudira, Ustaz Shukarti Aswain, her mother just passed away, and I'd like to recite dua for us as well as Ustaz Shukarti's mother.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen Sayyidina wa nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma aj'al awwala liqa'ina hadha salahan wa awsatahu falahan wa akhirahu najahan. Allahumma aj'al awwalahu rahmatan wa awsatahu ni'matan wa akhirahu takrimatan wa maghfira. Alhamdulillah alladhi tawada'a kullu shay'in li'azamatihi wa dalla kullu shay'in li'izzatihi wa khada'a kullu shay'in li'mulkihi واستسلم كل شيء لقدرته والحمد لله الذي سكن كل شيء لهيبته وأظهر كل شيء بحكمته وتصاغر كل شيء لكبريائه اللهم أيقظنا في أحب الساعات إليك يا ودود يا ذا العرش المجيد فعال لما يريد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار برحمتك يا عزيز يا غفار يا كريم يا ستار يا رب العالمين اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم ثبتنا وثبت موتانا على الإيمان خاصة والدة المديرة يا ربنا يا الله تقبل منا بحرمة حبيبك المصطفى بحرمة سر سورة الفاتحة
Assalamu alaikum. Thank you again. Now I would like to invite Shaykh Hisham and his entourage to have a tour of our madrasa.